Here, we have the so-called pseudo-classes and elements. They are simply selectors that we append to other selectors to make them more specific. Note that they are all preceded by a colon. Most of them are fairly self-explanatory, so we'll go right ahead and look at some examples. The first two, link and visited, can only be applied to the anchor tag. Link will match links that has not yet been bruised, and visited will match links that have been bruised. Hover applies when the mouse pointer hovers over that element, and active matches elements that are being activated, in this case by a mouse click. Note that for hover to work, it must come after link and visited, and for active to work, it must come after hover. Focus can be used on elements that can receive focus, such as with this input element. However, this pseudo class won't work in Explorer. The difference between active and focus is that active will only last for the duration of the click, while focus lasts until the element loses focus. First child matches an element if it is the first child of the parent element. In this example, only the first link will become bold. The last pseudo class, lang, followed by a language parameter, will only apply to elements that use that specified language. Next, we have the pseudo elements. The first two can apply styles to the first letter and the first line in an element. They only work on block-level elements, such as paragraphs. The last two can be used to insert content before an element and after an element, using the content property